Welcome back, class. So, before we are going to start our discussion this morning, I would like everybody to please stand up and let us have our prayer. Okay, so, our topic this morning is all about the galaxies in the universe. So scientists have estimated that there are 200 billion to 200 trillion galaxies in the universe. So scientists pinag-estimate nila yung na merong dalawang daang billion na galaxies sa ating universe. So, scientists have also estimated that there are about approximately 100 billion stars in the Milky Way galaxy. So, sinasabi din ng mga scientists na meron din 100 billion stars sa ating Milky Way galaxy. So, the Andromeda galaxy is closest galaxy to the Milky Way. So, ano yung pinaka-closest galaxy na Milky Way? Very good. Ito ay ang Andromeda galaxy. Very good. So, galaxies comes in four different types. So, ano ba itong apat na different types ng ating galaxies? So, first is the spiral. Second, bar or spiral. Ang pangatlo is elliptical. And fourth is the irregular. So, remember that last our four types of galaxy. So, ano yung? Ulit? So, okay, the spiral, the barred spiral, elliptical, and the irregular. So, next is our galaxy, the Milky Way. So, we live in the Milky Way galaxy in one of the spiral arms. So, dito, tayo ay nagkatira sa Milky Way galaxy. So, the Milky Way is about 14 billion years old. So, do you even know, class, that Milky Way is about 14 billion years old? So, that's just remember that, class. So, the Milky Way rotates every 200 million years. So, yeah, ganun pala yung pag-rotate ng ating Milky Way. So, nag-rotate siya is about 200 million years. Okay. The Milky Way contains 100 billion stars, dust, and gas. So, ang ating Milky Way is mayroon siyang 100 billion stars, also dust, and gas. So, ganun yung ating Milky Way. So, it takes 100,000 years for light to get from the side of the galaxy to the other side. So, next is, scientists have predicted that the universe in the center of the Milky Way galaxy there is a giant black hole. So, sa center ng ating universe, there is a giant black hole. So, the sun's orbit around the Milky Way takes 225 million to 250 million years. So, yung pag-orbit ng ating sun sa Milky Way is nangyayari siya sa loob ng 200 million taon to 150 years. So, ganun yung tagal ng pag-orbit ng ating pag-rotate ng ating sun sa Milky Way. So, next is one giant star. So, ano ba itong one giant star? So, itong one giant star is ang ating sun. So, the sun is classified as a yellow dwarf star. So, si sun is classified siya na parang siyang isang dwarf star. So, the sun is the center of the solar system. So, siguro class lahat naman tayo ng alam natin na ang sun is siya yung center ng ating solar system. All the planets orbit the sun. So, lahat ng ating planet, yung 8 planets natin is nag-orbit siya sa sun. Okay, I'll do it. So, the sun has been observed for hundreds of years. So, Galileo's answer is that Newton discovered that the planets orbited the sun. So, ang nagka-discover ng planet na nag-orbit sa sun is, sino yung dalawa? Si Sir Isaac Newton and Galileo. Okay, very good. So, next here. So, what makes night and day? So, may idea ba kayo kung ano to? So, spins, Earth spins on its axis. So, nangyari yung day and night. It is because the Earth spins on its axis. So, the side of the Earth that is facing the sun will experience heat and light. So, pag yung side ng Earth is nag-face siya sa sun, so, ang mangyari is yung day or light. So, kapag naman si Earth is hindi siya nag-face sa sun, so, ito yung tinatawag na darker or ito yung night. Okay. What do planets orbit the sun? So, why do planets orbit the sun? The sun's mass makes up 99% of the solar system. So, bakit nga ba yung mga planet is nag-orbit siya sa sun? Because sun is napaka high yung mass ng sun, kaya nag-orbit lahat ng mga planet sa sun. So, gravitational pull. So, gravitational pull is the invisible force that pulls object toward an object with greater mass. No? Next is the heliocentric model of the universe. So, helios. So, helios is Greek word for sun. And next is heliocentric theory. So, ito naman yung heliocentric theory is the sun is the center of the solar system. So, okay, that's all class for part. Okay, mayroon akong ibibigay na activity sa inyo. Okay. Activity. So, ito yung gagawin natin activity class. So, pakikuha ng inyong activity notebook and then kopyahin lang ito and then sagutin. Okay? So, 1 to 4 lang kasi yung ika-5 is bonus na lang sa inyong class. Okay? So, okay, are you done copying? Okay, very good class. So, ilagay lang dito sa unahan yung mga papers niyo kasi mamaya i-check lang natin yun. So, that's all for this morning, and next meeting we will proceed to our next topic. So, and I hope you have learned something today, and thanks for all the cooperation. Okay, goodbye class.